The complement system is an essential and powerful part of our immune defense system. Its main function is to coordinate the destruction and removal of infectious organisms, known as pathogens, or damaged cells in our body that need to be replaced. The complement system consists of a cascade of proteins, which activate each other by cleavage, the process of splitting each protein one by one. The complement system may be activated by three different pathways: the alternative, classical, and lectin pathways that all run through complement C3, the central protein in the cascade. C3 serves as the master switch, controlling all downstream effectors that ultimately cause destruction of the cell. The alternative pathway is spontaneously activated through direct binding of complement to a pathogen or damaged host cell to help the body clear away debris. The classical pathway is activated when an antibody, a protein produced by our immune system, recognizes and binds to a component on the surface of a foreign cell, forming an immune complex, starting an immune response that targets the pathogen for destruction. The lectin pathway is activated by natural molecules in our body that recognize sugars at the surface of infectious organisms. In situations where the complement system becomes overactivated, it results in immune attack, the destruction of healthy cells, and ultimately causes illness to the person. Paroxysmal nocturnal hemoglobinuria, PNH, is a rare, acquired, potentially life-threatening blood disorder, characterized by chronic complement-mediated destruction of red blood cells, hemolysis, and formation of life-threatening blood clots, also known as thrombosis. In PNH, stem cells acquire a gene mutation which results in the production of abnormal blood cells. These defective red blood cells, white blood cells, and platelets lack the connector, known as GPI, for two important surface proteins, CD55 and CD59, that regulate complement activity. As a result, the complement protein C3 becomes unregulated, triggering all downstream effectors that ultimately cause destruction of blood cells. In intravascular hemolysis, the formation of the membrane attack complex, known as MAC, creates holes in red blood cells, causing them to rupture inside blood vessels. At the same time, extravascular hemolysis is caused by C3b being deposited on the surface of defective red blood cells, tagging them for removal and resulting in their destruction in the liver and spleen. Platelets are also susceptible to excessive activation and cell aggregation, resulting from the presence of extra C3a, C5a, and MAC, increasing the risk of developing deadly blood clots. Current treatment blocks the complement protein C5, which prevents MAC forming holes on red blood cells inside blood vessels. However, this does not act upon C3-related extravascular hemolysis, which continues to cause severe anemia and transfusion dependency in many PNH patients. Inhibiting the C3 protein may prevent both intravascular and extravascular hemolysis. When the complement system becomes overactivated, medical treatment is required to regain control and protect the body from immune attacks. APL2 is a pegylated cyclic peptide inhibitor of complement C3. Pegylation helps keep APL2 in the body longer, reducing dosing frequency. The peptide portion of APL2 binds to enough C3 to prevent it from completing the complement cascade, helping the body regain control by preventing excessive complement activity and protecting it from abnormal immune attacks. Multiple global clinical trials are underway to determine if C3 inhibition provides improved clinical outcomes compared with current standards of care.